For those that are new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications to be notified whenever a brand new video is posted onto this channel. Thank you all so much for your continued support. Now let's begin. The six Infinity Stones are some of the most powerful gems in all of history within the Marvel Universe, but together, they make up in being the most powerful weapon in all of creation, capable of anything and everything when placed on the Infinity Gauntlet. Now, there is a significant difference in naming the six Power Stones held by Thanos in the comics and in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and those are the Infinity Gems in the comics and the Infinity Stones in the movies. Now, it's really up to you, the viewer, entirely in deciding on whether or not you want to refer to them as the Infinity Stones or Infinity Gems, but just as a minor nitpick between both, that is the only difference we have between the Infinity Stones and the Infinity Gems when comparing the movies to the comics, by reference to paraphrasing. Now, having to follow the movies and the movies only, within the Marvel Cinematic Universe, the Infinity Stones are a direct result of the universe's creation having to be spawned as a result of the action of the four cosmic entities. Now you might be asking, who are these four cosmic entities that created these Infinity Stones? They are Death, Entropy, Infinity, and Eternity. Now, Infinity is the expansion of all things within the existing universe, the ever so expanding growth of the universe itself, whereas Eternity is the physical presence and the physical manifestation of what the universe is entirely, which in a nutshell, both Infinity and Eternity are the expansion of life and the presence of life, including the universe itself, whereas Death and Entropy are the exact opposite. Now, when having to look at all six of the Infinity Stones, one must beg the question as to what each individual stone is capable of, as we're going to begin with the Reality Stone, also known as the Aether. Now, the Reality Stone grants the user power to physically manipulate matter. Now, in Thor the Dark World, we get to see how Malekith, the villain, wants to use this red liquid called the Aether to turn matter into dark matter because of his evil ways. Now, we also get to see how the reality and perception of reality was manipulated directly as a result of the Reality Stone having to be used in that film. Now, by the end of Thor the Dark World, we get to see how two Asgardians hand over the Reality Stone to the Collector, because apparently the Collector is one that could not be suspected in keeping any of the Infinity Stones intact, which apparently they didn't want to keep the Space and Reality Stone in the same room in Asgard during the time. They simply handed on over the Reality Stone to the Collector, in which in Avengers Infinity War, we see how Thanos had managed to not only beat down the Collector, but gain direct access and obtaining the Reality Stone for himself. Now, in turn, the Reality Stone is basically a wishing stone where it can grant the user anything they wish that can change the course of reality itself and does not obey the laws of physics. Now, when looking at the Space Stone, we also get to see how Thanos had managed to use that to his advantage in the Avengers Infinity War movie by smashing the Tesseract and using the Space Stone as a means of teleportation, in which in the Avengers Infinity War movie, that was all we saw from the Space Stone as Thanos was using it on the Infinity Gauntlet, which in turn the Space Stone gives the user power over space itself. And anyone holding the Space Stone can create a portal from one part of the universe to another in simply having to flow through the universe without any efforts. In the Marvel films, the Space Stone is hidden within a blue cube called the Tesseract, in which, as I just stated, Thanos had crushed in Avengers Infinity War to gain the Space Stone for himself. Now, the third Infinity Stone is the Mind Stone, also seen on Loki's scepter and on the forehead of Vision. Now, this is most interesting considering that Loki's blue glowing scepter did house the Mind Stone after all. As seen in the first Avengers film, the Mind Stone lets the owner control the mind of others. But it's not also the ability of the stone allowing you to control the mind of others, but as seen on Vision, it allows the stone to grant powers such as super strength and the ability to fly through walls like a ghost that make the Mind Stone ever so dangerous, which currently had resided on Vision's forehead, but now on the Infinity Gauntlet that Thanos wields. Now, when being able to access the full powers of the Mind Stone, it can connect to every single mind in the universe at once. The Mind Stone's power are maximized to its strongest, and thus later allowing the host, using the Mind Stone with its full powers unleashed, to control anybody or anything it wields by simply having the control over their mind. Now, the fourth Infinity Stone on the list is the Power Stone. Now, the Power Stone is exactly what it's made out of. out to be, and thus giving the host lots of energy, lots of power, and the ability to even destroy entire planets, as seen during Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, during Guardians of the Galaxy 1, Ronan the Accuser was the first one to steal it and threatening to wipe out an entire race simply by using the Power Stone to his advantage. Now, let's not also forget the Power Stone is also able to grant the host omnipotence at once, with its full powers having to be tapped into. So once the powers of the Power Stone is fully accessible, basically the user of the stone has infinite potential in destroying whatever it is they please. Now, the fifth Infinity Stone on our list is the Time Stone. Now, the Time Stone actually resides in the eye of the Agamotto pendant revealed in Doctor Strange. Now, the Time Stone allows the bearer to manipulate time, allowing them to either rewind or fast forward through the events, which can allow the host to see further into the future, as Doctor Strange did in the Avengers Infinity War movie, and seeing 14,500,000 different outcomes of the Avengers versus Thanos, with only one outcome of them winning. Now, when accessing the full powers of the Time Stone, this would ultimately allow the host to access any and all given points in the past and in the future with complete control over time itself once the full access of the stone has been fully utilized. Now, with the power of the Time Stone, one can simply control time and ceasing time to exist entirely. Now, the sixth and final stone that is wielded on the Infinity Gauntlet is known as the Soul Stone. Now, this stone allows the wielder to manipulate the souls of both the living and the dead, and it contains its own heavenly realm called the Soul Realm. Now, the Soul Stone can take possession of any and or living dead souls from history and can alter them, change them, and even have their abilities be accessed in the afterlife within the Soul Realm, which ultimately the Soul Stone acts as a gateway between one dimension and another, hence the soul world in connection to reality. Now, in the comics, just as we saw in Avengers Infinity War, Thanos had assembled the Infinity Gauntlet by gathering all the stones and wiped out 50% or half of the universe's population with just the snap of his finger, and he used his power to ascend to a higher state of being, but in abandoning his physical body in the comics, he separated from the gems, allowing his daughter Nebula to seize it. Now, she lacks Thanos' focus and determination and was defeated by the Marvel heroes after gaining the access to the Infinity Gems in the comics, and the godlike entity the Living Tribunal stepped in to separate the gems entirely, distributing them to a new group known as the Infinity Watch, headed and led by Adam Warlock, which we haven't seen in any of the Avengers films, or at least for the time being. Now, in order to understand the gravity and power of all six Infinity Stones on the Infinity Gauntlet, in Universe 616, once Thanos had collected and gathered all of the Infinity Stones in using the Infinity Gauntlet, he was actually able to defeat and imprison all of the cosmic entities within that universe, which basically allowed Thanos, in certain versions of the comics, to basically be unstoppable and indestructible in nature. Now, as revealed in Thanos Quest Number 2, the Infinity Stones were originally a part of an all-powerful sentient being of limitless power, later referred to as Nemesis. Now, at one time, Nemesis was the only living being in all of reality, and the being itself was incredibly lonely in terms of existence, that it eventually had to kill itself, and it was reincarnated as six Infinity Gems, which of course each gem had been associated with a different face of existence: power, space, mind, soul, time, and reality. But in time, just as many other things, that source material was ultimately retconned. And with that, it's already been proven that the stones have already set the example of what limitless power is. And with all six, nothing, including cosmic beings and all those of great power, can rival what the Infinity Gauntlet represents, with all six of the mightiest stones in existence intact. Those with every stone in their grasp are also beyond abstracts. It's been shown that the stones also allow the wielder to seemingly go through endless loops of time, knowing everything as it is and as it once was, knowing all that has happened and going to happen in the future, with endless power that can wipe out entire multiverses and timelines. And although the Marvel Cinematic Universe has severely nerfed the concept behind the Infinity Stones and the Infinity Gauntlet, they still hold truth as to what they originally are. Now, you might be wondering if the Infinity Stones, along with the Infinity Gauntlet, have ever been defeated before, and the answer to that question is yes. Once by the Living Tribunal, and once by Doctor Doom by absorbing the powers of the Beyonders. Now, Thanos had been stopped before, depending on which version of the Marvel comics we're looking at, but thus far, anyone else who is not a celestial being cannot wield the powers of the Infinity Stones. But in the end, I want to know your thoughts down in the comment section below. What is your favorite Infinity Stone and why? And what are your overall thoughts having to look at the Infinity Gauntlet and comparing it from the Marvel Cinematic Universe to the comics? Which version of the Infinity Stones and the Infinity Gauntlet do you guys prefer more between the MCU and the comics? Let me know down below. Thank you all so very much for watching. If you guys are new to this channel, then don't forget to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button, turn on all notifications, and slap a like down below if you guys love Marvel. If you guys love comics in general, tune back in for more. If you guys want to watch more videos such as this, make sure to check out the description box down below for more awesome goodies such as this video and many more. Thank you all once again, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody.